Incoming Yahtzee.
It's Yahtzee time.
Oh. Hello.
Hello.
Hey.
It's the internet.
We're so happy to see you.
Yes.
Can you see
now
me?
Now we see you.
There we go.
Yay.
Hey.
Hey.
What's
up? How's it going?
I can't. That's good. How are you?
Good. Good. Welcome to Desert Bus.
Mm-hmm.
There's
nothing.
Oh, what? What?
Sorry, I was just messing with my webcam settings.
That's hilarious. We're getting trolled by Yahtzee.
Yeah, the most terrifying thing I've seen.
Wait, does that
meow?
That is so entrenched in the uncanny valley.
Yeah. Product.
It was.
And flashing at pieces of string.
He was. He was a cat the whole. Time. He was a cat the whole time.
Oh, this is getting worse and worse.
Yahtzee the demon cat.
Okay, I'm gonna get this now. Okay.
Double troll.
Now how we'll do it.
I was a lot better before I soiled myself. What is going on?
Cross over sometime.
What was that?
I thought you wanted to do another unskippable crossover sometime.
Not anymore. Or at least from a great distance.
Yeah, I'm gonna pick this thing up now.
Wow.
Awesome.
None of our guest calls have
did that.
None of our guest calls have trolled us
That's
until
right.
now.
Double troll.
Yes, I deliberately did the cat.
The cat
was... Mm-hmm.
Wow. So, hi.
Yeah, sorry. I guess I'm probably not at the top there.
No, that's fine. That's fine. We're just glad that you were, you were able to call in again. Alex, could you turn Yahtzee up at all?
Yes, I can.
It sounds like he's
starting.
Yeah, he's starting to come out.
What was that?
This is the third time, isn't it?
I think so. Yeah.
I think so.
Yeah. What? It's 8 in the evening. It's 8 at night here. What time is it for you? It must be the morning.
It is a beautiful, sunny Brisbane afternoon. 2 o'clock in the afternoon.
Oh, great!
Nice.
It's a.
I'm here in my lounge.
It's a cold, damp, and frosty November evening in Victoria.
Yeah. Yeah.
So you win.
Yes.
Also, you're not playing Desert Bus, so you win.
Double
yes.
win.
Yes, yes. It is a shame.
Yeah.
So I
Whoa.
Have a.
I just heard a very strange noise coming from upstairs.
That's not on our end.
Are they trolling cats?
It's coming from inside the house. I have an extensive amount of questions here, and I will try to gloss over the ones that you always get. But
yeah, try not to go with where do you get your ideas?
How you talk so fast?
Yeah,
we're used to that.
Do you speed up your voice? okay. So, what's this? Dear Dr. Yahtzee, what is the strangest fan moment you've ever had? I assume that means involving one of your fans.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Well, the first one that leaps to mind when you bring that up was at the opening of Manabar Melbourne.
Okay.
Which would have been about last year sometime. Was it earlier this year? I don't know. It's all a fog. And... Yeah, a fellow with a beard and a hat like mine said that he just wanted to shake my hand. So
okay.
I let him shake my hand and he said, thank you, I just wanted to touch you. So I said, that's a bit creepy, man.
Yeah.
And he said, no, it's all right, I just wanted to touch you because you've touched Gabe Newell.
That's...
I said that was a bit creepy too.
That went from creepy to just insulting.
Do you remember when we were at GameX in Philadelphia, and this guy walked past in a shirt and vest and hat and with a goatee and everything, and you turned to me and you were sort of like, so is he cosplaying me? And we, I think we determined that he was, and it was weird.
Yes, not even the first time I've seen someone cosplaying as me. Actually, there was a really good one recently, for the last Halloween, I think, that got sent, a picture got sent around on Twitter of someone wearing like a yellow suit with the big cardboard zero punctuation pieces on.
Yeah, that was quite clever.
If you're gonna cosplay something, cosplay as that. Because cosplaying as me personally as a man, that's entering the creepy area.
Are there any plans to expand the mana bar into Sydney? We could really use one of those.
Yes, I bet you could. It's a bit. At the moment, we're just concentrating on the two venues, but it's not off the cards. New mana bars anywhere is not off the cards. We're just concentrating on like paying off our debts, making some real money, and we'll see where we go. I guess we're living from day to day at present. All
right.
Apparently, there's one opening.
About a sequel to Mogworld or second novel.
Yes, I'm not sure what I should say because I don't think it's been officially announced by Dark Horse yet.
Oh well then.
But
I will
say that the current draft is currently with the editor, and I'm waiting to hear back.
Awesome.
Yeah.
And it's not a sequel to Mogworld, but it does share a character with it, and I'll stop there.
All right.
Have you read Mogworld, Graham?
What?
Have you read Mogworld, Graham?
Yes, there was a people have
I can't think of a word.
No, I had word. Well, I don't get a lot of chance to read books, but I had to after people on Twitter were like, "Lol, there was a reference in Mogworld to you guys." So
What?
Was there? Because that's kind of news to me.
Well, then I don't
awesome.
Understand. What the hell were these people telling me?
I don't know.
Maybe they're just trying to get you to read the book.
Yeah.
They're cheeky buggers.
Yeah. See if you recognize something.
Yeah.
All right.
Is that an audiobook coming
out? Years back.
Get it for Graham? Audiobook, maybe?
Yeah.
Are there any recent games that you would recommend?
What have I just been playing? I've just been playing Skyrim. I was actually writing my review for that today. And it's quite promising in this age of really inorganic corridor sightseeing tour shooters that we can finally have another game that actually lets you do things other than go to the thing and shoot the thing.
Yeah, I know. There's no hide. It's really immersive, too.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. It's really glitchy, though. I think talking about it with my friends, we've all come to the conclusion that pretty much every single boss fight you have to beat by finding an exploit. Because with dragons, it's always stand in an archway, like it's an earthquake.
Exactly.
And then, like, maneuver pillars in between you and the dragon when it breathes on you.
Yeah.
Actually, what I found useful was to do the quest with the dog. And the dog, when you fight a dragon, is really, really good at pulling the dragon's aggro.
Right.
And the dog is invincible.
Huh.
Oh, is it?
Invincible.
So the dragon
dog.
Is just like there, breathing fire at this immovable dog, while I run up and chop it in the ass with a big axe.
That's right. Very clever.
There are worse strategies. Yes.
Yeah. Although it kind of undermines this feeling that you're supposed to be the legendary dragon slayer, and you're the only one who can do it.
Yeah.
When you've got a dog, you need a dog to help you out with that.
Do you have any comment on the similarity between the ZP imp and the android?
Oh, yes, this one again.
I'm sorry.
This has been brought to my attention a few times. No, it's fine. I really don't know at this point. I mean, it looks similar, but it's not that complicated an idea.
Alright, fair enough.
I think it would be flattering myself too much to say that I was like popular enough for Google to rip off. But even if they did rip me off, what the hell am I going to do about it? Because they're fucking Google.
Yes.
They own everything.
Pretty much. They own me. They own you. What do they probably own that kitten face that I put on.
What do your parents think about your work? Because this is someone who's been asking this question because they want to get into doing work in video games, but their family thinks that video games are stupid.
Yeah, well, my family have never really approved of what I do. My hot tip in that regard is to move 12,000 miles away.
So good.
That seems like
yeah, last time I saw my mum when she came to Australia, she said, we were talking about my work, and she said, as long as you're happy. That's the passive possible way. So I said she was being passive aggressive, and she started crying, and it was all good.
Super. So what's your stance? So what's your stance on erotic Star Trek fanfiction?
Only if it's Counselor Troy having sex with me.
Get on it.
The chat's all over it.
Yeah.
We'll, you have your instructions. Go.
Oh, we'll
but don't
that'll
show
be done
me
by tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
Okay, 5 minutes.
Are you
I
looking
just realized how horrifying that would probably be.
Are you looking forward to are you looking forward to Serious Sam 3 at all in regards to it being, you know, an antithesis to all the generic shooters that are coming out?
I am, yes. Yes, that's my that's something I'm looking forward to in the coming weeks, because I'm a fan of the run around the classic style shooter that Painkiller did so well and the original Serious Sam did so well. I was a little bit concerned looking at screenshots of Serious Sam that it seemed to be very dusty and very brown, like a lot of modern shooters, and it was in a ruined city, and I saw a helicopter in the background, and I was like, bloody hell, what's that? But I saw, I did watch a trailer of E3, and Serious Sam was running around in a big group of monsters really fast, and the end tagline was, no cover, all man, and I had a little squirt.
Yeah, I'm very excited about Serious Sam 3.
Yeah, I've been playing Saints Row 3, actually. Just started that one.
That's what he wants to play. Yeah, exactly. And how is it?
That's one I was looking forward to, because Saints Row 2 I liked very much indeed.
Oh, yeah.
But what's disappointing is that when you're building a character, gender is no longer a slider. I thought that was one of the most progressive things about Saints Row 2 is that you could be a transsexual if you wanted.
I've got
that, yeah.
Really?
I had
a girlfriend at the time who was so into that.
Are you enjoying it, though? Is it living up to Saints Row 2?
Well, I haven't played very much of it so far, but it's pretty fun. If it lives up to Saints Row 2, it's pretty much just because it seems to have copy-pasted a lot of stuff from Saints Row 2, but we'll see how we go. I haven't really gotten into the main story yet, which I hear is pretty good.
All right. Have you ever have you ever played a video game and come to a section that, on purpose or not, has made you laugh yourself to tears?
Oh, I wouldn't say to tears, because I'm emotionally repressed and British like that.
Well, you're British.
Yeah.
A game quite recently that I found weirdly amusing was Driver San Francisco.
It just had
some stuff that made me laugh, because I really liked this whole sort of magical realism angle it was taking with the main character with this ability to it was pretty much a straight 70s style cop show thing, except for the fact that this guy could possess people.
Yeah.
And they didn't shy away from it in the story. They referred to it, which I thought was pretty brave, but it worked out pretty well for me. But I remember it having quite a few lines that made me laugh. But if you're talking about just a single line from a game that just made me go, that kind of caught me off guard, it was in Uncharted 2, of all things.
Yeah.
And I was trying not to laugh, because Nathan Drake is a smug twat and I hate him. But there's a joke in the first level of that game in the museum where you're climbing off a building and your support character goes in your ear, there's a guy above you, and you look up and there's a guy standing on the ledge above you. So you do like the finishing kill where you grab him and pull him off the ledge. And the guy in your voice goes, "There's a guy below you, a guy below you."
So that made me laugh. Very well.
But nothing Nathan Drake says made me laugh. It just made me fill with hatred and disgust.
Driver San Francisco is actually our episode of Unskippable for tomorrow. So.
Oh really?
Yeah, we figured we should put up an episode about driving while we're doing Desert Bus.
Yeah.
The one thing that we didn't actually comment on from the episode is that in the opening cutscene, the guy's breaking out of, like, he's in an armored car being transported, and he has like acid or something and breaks his bonds, and there's two guys in the cab of the armored car and two guys in the back of the armored car in the same room with him. And it shows him breaking out of his bonds and then getting pinned to the wall by one of the guys. And then it cuts away, and it cuts back, and he's driving the armored car. And it never deals with how he subdued these four guys.
Can you even get to the cab of an armored car from the back door?
No, you can't. Who knows?
Maybe he just jumped through the wall.
Just phased right through it.
Yep.
Or just punched his way through because he's so big.
Dear Supreme Overlord and Infinitely Wise Dr. Yahtzee.
Oh, don't say that. That's getting creepy too.
Where do you see the gaming industry going in the next decade?
You know, what's interesting about the game industry now is that I have no idea. And very few people seem to know at all. Because for the longest time, the games industry was just about having the best graphics in your console. And that's... We kind of reached the peak of that. I mean, graphics can still get better, but we're at a point where developers, third-party developers, don't really have the resources to develop on really high levels. So that's what led to this weird sort of experimental period with motion controls and 3D and Kinect and whatever else. And your guess is as good as mine at this point, because what I think we need to really shake up things, and I remember making this point in a column once, what we need is another dual analog sticks, which is something that adds a whole new dimension to gaming, and we wonder how we ever did without it.
Right. But that isn't actually adding a new dimension, that being the third one, which is hokey.
Yeah.
How would not make sequels? New original ideas. Oh my god.
Well, what's cool about this year is that most of the titles are third installments of trilogies, so hopefully there'll be some new installments next year in the next round of IPs.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to wrap up with it. Dear Mr. Dr. Yahtzee, could you please critically review Graham's facial hair?
I can't actually see it on the stream at the moment. I'm a bit behind you.
Oh, hang on. Can you switch back to...
I can still see myself talking. It's probably going to be talking for a while. So while I'm waiting to look at your facial hair, do we have another question?
Yeah, sure. Two questions. Are you going to... one of them is about Manabar in the U.S., which you sort of dealt with. Are you going to be doing an audiobook for Mogworld?
Yes, as I said on my blog recently, I am planning to do so. It's a matter of recording it with my home recording setup. But at this point, I'm not really sure how I'm going to distribute it, but there are channels we can ask these things. Oh, I can see you now.
Oh, good.
There we go. Yay.
Oh.
you're looking very handsome.
Why, thank you. So are you.
Thanks. Yes, we both have rather similar facial hair. I think mine may be more luxuriant, though.
I would bet that, after what hour of Desert Bus are we into? After 50 hours of Desert Bus, pretty much anything of yours would be more luxuriant than mine.
Oh, excuses.
Also, you're just better.
I know. No, you're a lovely man, Graham, and I love you very much.
You just can't talk very fast. As fast as you.
Dear Yahtzee, please keep your voice out of my every condescending thought.
I think it's impossible.
Okay, I will do that.
I get the impression that this person now thinks condescending things in your voice, which is actually kind of awesome.
Yeah.
You have a lot of real estate in their head.
Yeah. I see that a lot on like tweets and stuff, people saying I'm just watching like 500 episodes of Zero Punctuation and now everything I read is in Yahtzee's voice. That sort of thing. So I guess I'm permeating the collective unconscious. Yeah. Like that one episode of Doctor Who.
Matt Smith or David Tennant was a question.
Ooh. You know what? I haven't watched any Matt Smith, and the reason why is because David Tennant completely pissed me off. I completely went off Doctor Who because of David Tennant.
I would recommend... was it David Tennant or was it Russell T.
Yeah.
Davies?
Yeah.
It was probably Russell T. Davies. Yeah, I was just really annoyed how, like, you know, every episode was just the entire universe is about to be destroyed.
Mm. I would,
and now we're going to fix it in 20 minutes and kind of like devalue the whole universe destroying plot for another time.
Yeah, I'm not going to go all nerd wank on you, but I'd recommend giving Matt Smith a shot if you get a chance.
Yeah, people keep telling me that.
Oh, well, fair enough. Who is your favorite pony? From the new My Little Pony series.
I have not watched that.
Smart.
Would you like to turn them all into glue?
Literally.
I have a creepier one than the Dr. Supreme awesome person. You want the creepy question?
Yeah, sure.
Alright. So it says, Dear Dr. Yahtzee, what was the worst game you've ever reviewed? Also, I'm a huge fangirl and want to bear your babies.
I agree, you probably do.
Well played.
The worst game I ever reviewed, I've been asked this a few times, probably still Too Human by Silicon Knights, which was absolutely dreadful.
Oh yeah.
And particularly disappointing because they made Eternal Darkness, which was actually quite good.
Yeah, great game.
What's your favorite weird bug that you've encountered in Skyrim?
Oh, because everyone's got one, haven't they?
I got one too.
Very first session I was playing Skyrim, I was in a town and there was an old lady hovering about 20 feet in the air. And then she started walking and then she descended as if down a staircase and then disappeared into the ground. I will always remember you, ghost stairs lady. I don't know where she is now, but I like to think she's happy.
She was never heard from again. Did you see these?
In a bit of proxy.
Did you say that? Ooh,
literary reference that nobody got.
did you see the?
Someone on the chat, tell me what the Lidenbrock Sea is from.
The what?
Someone in the chat, say what the Lidenbrock Sea is from.
All right, let's see what. Let's see what the chat has to say. There's a lag, of course, so it takes a sec for the chat to catch up.
Mm-hmm. Delay.
Yahtzee is so much win. Mary Poppins. You're a charismatic stallion. Mining for iron. Never forget Ghost Lady. Journey to the Center of the Earth?
That's the one.
There we go.
There it is.
Journey to the Center of the Earth by Jules Verne.
Someone finally got it. Have you seen the Hitman Absolution playthrough trailer? If so, thoughts?
No.
All right.
I usually avoid watching trailers and playing demos because I'm going to be playing the games anyway, and it's not good to go into these things with a pre-existing concept, you know.
Fair enough. We have an ongoing challenge to. Collect facts. Actually, sorry, you can write them down. To collect facts, and someone's giving us $5 for each fact we collect. We can only get one from each individual person. Can you provide us with some sort of trivial fact?
Okay. I was prepared for this.
Oh, good.
Yay!
John Patrick Lowry, the voice actor who voices the sniper in Team Fortress 2, is married to Ellen McLean, who voices the announcer and GLaDOS in Portal.
Really? Wow. Oh my god!
I did not know that. That's wow. That's
and
a really good fact.
Rejoiced. Nice. My Valve fan.
Thank you.
There's someone in the chat asking Yahtzee's opinion on the place of used games in the industry.
Okay, sure.
Well, I well, my problem with pre-owned games is the fact that it takes money away from developers. Mm-hmm. Because when you buy a pre-owned game, basically all the profit from that goes to the retailer, mm-hmm. not the developers or the publishers, and that's why retailers really push the pre-owned thing, like trade in like 8 of your favorite games for one new thing that you will hate.
Oh, ye
games. And it's generally evil because they'll take a game from you that you paid like $100 for and give you like $5, and then they'll sell the game for like $95. Right. Bucks.
Which is why I don't miss working at GameStop.
So it's annoying, and it's annoying that it's one of the only ways to get old games.
Yeah, when we're buying games for Unskippable, because we have to buy so many, we're frequently looking for pre-owned. Also, a lot of the games we do are terrible and we don't really care. But it's so disheartening when it's like, oh, okay, they have a pre-owned one, and it's maybe $3 cheaper than the game brand new.
Yeah.
I guess, how do you quantify a thing like how much less worth something is if someone else has touched the box?
Yeah.
It's
like driving a used car for
that. So, speaking of a box, we have a box of delight here. Alex, you want to go back to the wide shot? So this box of delights contains many things related to yourself, and this is an auction that we're going to be doing while we have you on the phone. This is the Mega Zero Punctuation Prize Pack, including, put that on the document cam. This is the limited edition Zero Punctuation poster, signed by yourself, I believe.
Yes, they sent me a load, and I signed them, and I sent them back. And they're good posters. I had a look at it, and if everyone from the Escapist is listening to this, you told me what the posters were for after the posters arrived at my house, so I may have accidentally given one away to a friend. So whatever the number of signed posters you think you have, it's one less than that.
Can you switch back to this for a second?
There's a spelling mistake on that poster. Can you find it?
Yay! It's not just my
phone anymore. That would drive me absolutely nuts.
Oh, I think I just saw it. I don't think Saman is a real word.
What? Yes, they spelled semen with an A.
Where? On the left.
How did you see that?
Yeah, it's top left somewhere.
Yeah. It's just
Now it's big.
Okay,
you don't have to look out for semen.
Yeah.
Alex is
learning
a hard lesson.
Okay, it's bottling. Back to what? So, not only does...
No, if there's a print run with a mistake on, then that eventually is worth more money, isn't it?
Yes, and you signed it, so there you go.
Yeah.
So this also has... Kathleen, walk us through what else is in this box of wonder.
It has a zero punctuation t-shirt, size extra large, for extra large people or for girls who want to turn them into dresses. One of those. It has another zero punctuation t-shirt, also size extra large, this one the I'm an Assassin one.
So it's the I'm an Assassin and the Allow Me to Hold Your Face Under the Putrescent Waters of Knowledge t-shirts.
Yes.
Additionally...
Not many t-shirts with quotes from recent videos, is there?
Want to get those closer?
Yeah.
Also,
love those things.
A pair of imps.
A mated pair.
Maybe. We don't know what they do.
And.
Maybe they'll make lots of things. Oh. Oh, man. Oh. Unfortunately, I will make a terrible model for this because it's a men's size extra large. Ooh. Zero punctuation imp hoodie.
Yay! Dude!
This is so cool.
Get one of those.
Oh, man.
Now one. Bye, Kat.
So we're going to auction this off, and we're going to have you encourage our bidders.
Okay.
Do not start bidding, chat.
Is bid brought down or?
No. Just we haven't begun it yet.
Yeah. Okay. And here come the rest.
Graham, you want to stand by to cue?
So we're firing our bid laser.
So, in case anybody watching is just joining us for this and wants to bid on this, there is a process to bid. There's a FAQ on desertbus.org. You need to have a registered donor account on desertbus.org, and you need to have a registered nickname in the IRC. This is for a variety of reasons, all of which are intended to prevent bullcrap bids and make this thing generally easier for us. Because we have enough crap to deal with during Desert Bus. We don't want to deal with chasing you people down.
Why is someone asking about ZP Imp erotic fanfiction on the chat?
No reason.
Why wouldn't they?
Could we get rid of that person?
I would probably,
it's already probably exist if you search for it, right?
So Yahtzee, if you don't think that these people are bidding enough, you are welcome to encourage them or berate them. And
like golden flats.
Yes,
you can.
Hey, I will be Bob Geldof at the Live Aid thing.
Excellent.
You are our Bob Geldof.
Or is that a reference that's a bit too old for you, young whippersnappers?
Oh, I got it.
No, we got it. We're
good. He was on Top Gear recently. We're all about Bob Geldof.
No, we got it.
Top Gear is not the great representative.
Top Gear USA. So good.
Oh, no.
I'm kidding. It's horrible.
Okay. BidBot is live.
Wait, do not start bidding until BidBot says in the chat. There we go. The auction has begun. Okay. All right.
Yeah. 300.
300.
700.
I'm out. You started it, though? You did do 300.
Wow.
700.
1,200.
1,200.
You crazy suckers.
Oh, sorry. Thank you.
Did you turn down that?
So, wow. 1,200.
Really? Wow.
Actually, I'm going to turn this down, Alex.
So I remember it took a while to get to 1,000 last time I was doing an auction with you guys.
Okay. Just
because
I was concerned about Art, this, and Yahtzee on the same fader. No? Okay, then don't worry about it. Sorry. Okay, so that ramped up quickly to $1,200.
Yeah. It's possible we climax a bit too fast there.
That doesn't normally
happen.
Not the
first time. Chat is confused.
Won't be the last.
$1,202. Because, why not?
That's more than $1,200, certainly.
Yeah.
But you can do better than that, I know.
$1,205 is not enough of an increase over $1,202 because...
Oh, it's the
2 cents.
$1,300
from not Michael J. Fox. I don't believe you. I think you are Michael J. Fox.
Yeah, I think you're blowing all your Michael J. Fox.
1337.37.
Oh, you nerd. Please add some more, sir. So that is not such a nerdy number.
Dave Random.
You mean
actually,
there's nerds here?
Dave Random made the nerdiest bid ever last night when we were auctioning off a custom-made Doctor Who scarf, and he bid 1963 and 11 cents because Doctor Who premiered in November 1963.
Oh.
Yeah. 1350.
Well, I premiered in 2007.
That's
if that helps.
1675.
Ice Pick. I haven't seen Ice Pick bidding this year.
Whoa.
1675.
Okay, I want this quintuple, man.
Wait, that was a huge jump from 1356 to 1675?
Ice Pick.
Wow.
Is 1675 a year?
1776 and 7 cents.
For America.
What happened in July?
The children!
Dave Random.
For freedom, I think.
Wow. America Day.
Hey, I want to insult you guys, but you're doing alright.
Yeah. So.
More money, please, you bastards.
1800.
Wow. Would you be willing to sweeten this pig a little bit, Yahtzee?
How?
I don't know.
How?
Well, I haven't got the prizes, you do.
Yeah, we do. Yeah. He can't get them to us in time to put them in the
1900.
You know that. Dr. Bobner Awesome at 1900. Wow. Wait, 1999-97. Wow.
Oh my god.
Okay.
I'm supposed to remember I had to pay for shipping on that.
That's true.
Right.
Offer to
So
yeah, you can just call people and insult them for a while as a little sweetener, see? You just call them on Skype.
So you just make their
1999-97 is the current leading bid. And I think we're gonna say going once on that. I think that this is I think that this has dealt with itself.
We have to get to the zero punctuation premiere year. That was 2007. Come on, that's just $8 more. You can manage that.
Oh, good idea.
2007.
Zero punctuation premiered in 2007. Someone bid 2007. Okay. Because otherwise, we will have to be waiting until we say, oh, wait.
Oh, I said 2007, and someone bid 2005 because obviously he really needed that $2.
Yeah, apparently.
You got all of you. And now no one can bid 2007.
That's right.
It has to be a $5
That's
increase.
Right.
But oh, no!
Dr. Bobner Awesome with 2005. Fantastic.
Let me think.
I could
sweeten this.
Nice overlay.
I could do something naughty.
Oh.
I could read a paragraph from the zero punctuation that's coming up this week.
Oh. Oh.
I like that.
At what level will the bidding have to get to for that to happen?
Oh,
make that happen.
3,000.
Make that happen, internet.
At what?
3,000. Make that happen, internet. 3,000.
Wow. So we gotta get another almost $900, or more than $900 out of this for that to happen. I can't hear you.
$2,500.
Sorry, once again?
$2,500.
Okay, $2,500.
And I will read the first paragraph of this week's Zero Punctuation that isn't out yet.
But we're gonna say going once, because there hasn't been any other bid since Dr. Bobner Awesome. I think we're gonna say. I think we're gonna say going twice to Dr. Bobner Awesome.
Yeah.
No one else is bidding.
Come on, guys.
Everyone spent a limb.
I want to hear this. Okay. It's like.
There it is in the chat. Going twice is in the chat.
Well, someone asked me to read erotic fan fiction there, but. I'll do that if we can get to 2,500. Sure, that's what people want.
Is that a real bid?
Wait.
No.
They haven't. That's 3,000?
No, that's not. They're not registered, unfortunately.
Oh right.
Oh okay.
We have to stick to our guns on that. So, with that in mind, I think that no other registered bidders are bidding. So I think that we have to say sold.
I should probably have called them all cunts more.
Yeah.
What a
sold
bunch
to
of
Dr. Bobner Awesome for $2,005. That is fantastic.
Yeah, I guess it's pretty good for the prize pack.
Wow, that's amazing.
What can you say to that? Clap, clap, clap.
Yeah, clap, clap, clap. So even though you're not reading us a paragraph from it, you said that this week's episode is Skyrim?
Yeah.
No, I'm writing it. I'm writing this week's... The one I'm writing this week is Skyrim, but that will go out next week. That's how my schedule works.
Well, can you tell us what this Wednesday's will be?
What?
Yeah, you can probably guess it's Modern Warfare 3.
Soon, Shooter Season 2011 will be over and you'll be free of this.
Battlefield.
Yes, yes. This notional theme I made up for myself and has now become an albatross about my neck. Another literary reference.
It's okay. We got that one. Or at least I did.
Some of us read books, except Graham.
I throw out these little feelers to gauge what sort of intellectual level I'm dealing with here.
Yeah, I get that.
Oh, yes.
Right. Okay, yeah. Sure, go for
it. Okay, Yahtzee, I have one quick question for you.
This kitty.
All right, we will ask the kitty.
It's scary.
All right, Crodo, go ahead. Ask the cat.
The kitten is waiting.
Okay, have you gotten any better at go-karting since GameX?
Yes. I was very bad at that.
I have a picture of you crashed still from GameX.
Mm-hmm. No, I haven't go-karted since then, actually. This kitten bothers me now. That was when we were hanging out with Brian O'Halloran, wasn't it?
Yeah, we were. That was a weird night.
And the girl, and that was girl cool. from Clerks too.
Yeah, it was two people from Clerks and us and Yahtzee go karting in Philadelphia.
That was
that sounds like a really bad joke. It was,
and I smashed into a wall because I don't drive.
Well, so did I because I don't either. So it's okay. We're all friends here.
Yeah. I think it was unfair to ask us to do that if we can't drive.
How dare they?
Yes, I'm very disappointed with Brian O'Halloran.
Yes.
I will not watch his films.
Although then we all beat the guild at laser tag because they suck.
Yeah.
So.
Right.
Yeah.
Nice. So I sat out of that one because laser tag always makes me sweaty and I hate it.
Mm. Fair enough.
Fun.
Well, hey, thank you so much for calling in and for helping out with that prize pack. $2,005 is nothing to be to turn our noses up at. Yeah, that's
awesome.
Wonderful.
Good sniff that in the way a small dog would sniff.
Oh no!
Is
that a corgi?
This is bizarre.
It's a corgi.
If at any point.
I love these webcam settings, I gotta say.
Yeah. If at any point...
I got loads of them here. I might save some for next year.
Yeah.
The cat one's pretty good.
If at any point during the run you feel like calling back in as a dog or cat, feel free.
Yes.
Catsy. Hey, the sparkle's coming out of my nose now.
Wow.
That's awesome.
Oh,
this is
so awesome.
Oh!
All right. Well.
Okay, I think I've messed you around enough.
No, that's fine.
I got
all day. Thanks for having me again, guys.
Well, thanks for having me. Really appreciate it.
Drive. You guys can ask. We'll continue to do so.
I'm sorry. I didn't catch
you guys
that.
Are kicking ass. Now you will continue to do so, I'm sure.
Well, yes. Thank you so much. Thank you for calling in. We really appreciate it.
Yeah, that was awesome.
Thank you. Always a pleasure, Graham.
Bye, Yahtzee.
And to you.
Bye,
Yahtzee.
Bye, Yahtzee.
Cheerio, all.
Bye.